Since 1956, this little coffee shop has been a mecca for European migrants.
There's some Macedonians and Greeks, but it's predominantly Italians.
Palermo, viva Palermo, Palermo, Palermo.
What do they do here? They play cards, they gossip, they argue. I think they're just trying to get out of the house to leave their wives alone. But
who's good at this game? Are you good at it?
You got to be lucky.
Some of them will sit here all day if they could. There's a lot of swearing in Italian. They're constantly arguing about who's going to pay because they all want to shout at each other their coffees every morning, which is very cute. It's always a competition too, I think, trying to take each other out with their $50 notes.
No problem. I'll bring it out to you.
Louise is a comparative newcomer to the Thornbury Espresso Bar.
There was two beautiful owners that's always owned this, and Vic passed away 2 years ago. No, that's all right.
Okay.
No, but he's a lovely man.
Long story short, it was Louise to the rescue.
I opened up Polino next door 10 years ago and I slowly got to know all of the old guys that come here. And then it was love at first sight after that. I couldn't say no.
And while she carried out some much-needed renovations, the regulars waited impatiently.
There'd be so many occasions we'd come here and there'd be just an old bloke sitting out the front waiting to find out what's happening and when we're reopening.
Fabio Bernardini was one of those who couldn't wait.
Louise say, no, 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 we still close because, you know, but try to push in, you know, me, I want to come in, you know.
Fabio and Dom are from different generations, but both have been coming to the Espresso Bar for decades.
When she kept that open and I seen the joy of these men here, I said, Louise, you're a valuable member of this community, man, because all these people that come here, they'll be home doing nothing, being isolated. They've got no one to talk to. And it gets the people out of their houses to come here, have a bit of a chit-chat. It was really emotional to see it back on track, you know?
We took the space over and opened up 3 days a week. Well, originally it was 2 days, but they talked me into giving them Wednesday.
Hang on, the clientele talked you into opening for another day?
Yeah, we start off with 2 days, but for them, they would love it 7 days a week, but that's not going to happen.
As things stand, the coffee shop is no money spinner. It's the weekend functions that bring in the cash.
I wish it was open every day, but it's only 2 days a week.
Well, I told her.
Sometimes, we tell her, but she wants to open up.
Yeah.
I don't want you to play favourites, yeah. But if you had a couple of favourites.
Tony, one of our regulars, is 92. How you going, Tony?
Good, that's
it. We went to his 90th birthday party with his family, which was really cute. And then there's a few others that love to bring me tomato plants, so they're definitely up there.
Why do you like to come here in particular, Fabio?
No, I meet some friends, have a talk, talk about sport, talk about fishing.
Do you talk in English or Italian or
both? Half and half. Mm-hmm. Mainly in Italian. A Napoli, al Maradona, 3-0.
Maria, Maradona.
Ciao bello!
Who's winning today?
The gentleman in there.
You're winning?
No, I'm not.
Does it get very competitive?
Yes. Of course.
The cards seem very serious business. Do the cards go flying?
Fly everywhere. Even table fly.
Table fly. What would your message be to Louisa?
I reckon you deserve the Darabin Council Nobel Peace Prize because you keep all these people connected.
So where will I find you guys, like, next week? Same time, same place?
Same time, same place. I'll be here.
Commentatore!
I hope she stays here for another 50 years.
Mm-hmm.
I really do, you know. You probably see me grumpy and miserable too, like you blokes.
What have they taught you?
Maybe that you get old pretty quickly. They're always joking about how they wish they were young. So, yeah, you've got to embrace and enjoy being young.
What do you hope the future of this space is?
Look, I'd love to say that I think that this will go forever, but who knows? Our generation don't go and play cards on their days off. Yeah, we'll see what happens. I couldn't not do it for the guys. So as long as they're around and coming in, the place will be open.
Beautiful story.
Louise is such a good egg.
An absolute champion. So that coffee shop, it doesn't make much. She only's opening it for those men so that they can have that community.
So here's the business model and here's our promise. They make those T-shirts. They look pretty cool anyway.
Yeah, they do.
Put them up for sale. We'll all buy hundreds across Australia. We'll all buy a Thornbury T-shirt and she can open 5 days a week. They'll go
for
forever.
For the guys. Oh, look, Fabio has heard that and he has written that out. He'll get that printed as a business plan and he'll be there on Monday being like, Lou, this is what we do.
I'll buy 10 T-shirts. Everyone watching,
it's
buy
on TV.
At least
You've
once.
Said that out loud.
Yeah, I have. The
she
cafe's
does such,
going forever.
Such great work, and all the men there, so beautiful. And doesn't Tony just have one of those faces where you're like, he's lived a life? It's absolutely that beautiful man.
Great story, Julie.